started a poem titled In an Unknown Land, and I hope you enjoy it. I try to fit in. In my nature and my culture, we respect people older than we are. Yes, yes, looking one into his or her eyes is a sign of disrespect. Becoming too polite was the best I thought. I tried it. In the mall, everywhere I go. The results were way beyond normal. I was treated like a puppet. A sponge, they called me. Even if one stepped on me, I said I was sorry. It didn't help. I was a typical example of a true Christian. When slapped on one cheek, turn the other. If I take off my native attire, will it make a difference? If I knot my tie firmly and strongly like the Irish, would it change who I am? Will it make a difference? Then, what must I do in a land so perfect, so peaceful, yet so strange? In a land still blinded to see the beauty it possesses? In a land in which I am judged by the wrong of a sister I don't know. A land that once suffered famine, hunger, castration, now looks at me in the same situation as the upbringer of hunger. What must I do? What must I do? I shall have nowhere to go, nowhere to run. In an unknown land so beautiful, yet so strange. Thank you very much. Now the second one is titled, Let Me Sleep. I hope you enjoy it too. She turned restless, back and forth, struggling through the night. She wanted to sleep, she tried to sleep. The day ahead was long. She tried to stand, the cock was crawling. Yet she cannot stand, she is tired. Sleepy through the night, she tried to sleep. Waking up was a fight. How do you sleep, yet not sleep? Wake, yet can't stand. I hear you sleep to rest, but she sleeps and slums. I want to wake, I want to run. I want to leave and not scream. When will I be a woman? I waddle through the mud, the quicksand where I was born. Every day, I live with a wish. I see people around sink as we wade together. People close to me, people I will remember. Come save me, take my hand. My voice echoed through the hills. Britain came with a tale of a visa. I wish I was told it is a monster, an empire that turned my land into this mud. But here she is offering me her tale, a way out. Out of this mud, I grabbed it. I see no monster, I see a savior, flying in red, white, and blue. For once I smiled. See my mud down below. I have escaped, have gone. My savior, oh my savior, should I follow her to a nest? Should I jump off somewhere, someplace I will feel safer, a place without the repute of monsters? Down below, I see a woman like myself, wrapping colors of green, white, and orange. She's so beautiful with kind eyes. I let loose, I land. It was soft, I am saved. Should I build a house? Should I leave right now? Let me sleep, let me wake. But the sand is soft, maybe too soft. I am sinking, I can't understand. I see her, she has many children. The hateful ones are called the right wing. They all fear them and they all scream. You can't sleep, you can't wake. Your mud is not entirely all muddy. Some parts are hard, go back to your mud. Our ground is all hard, we made it hard. Now we sleep, not like you. It's your fault. We don't cheer. Go away. Oh, let them stay. Let them walk. I hear some Irish say, we cheer. We love. We are Irish, not sinners. Okay, okay, you can walk, said a Falagan. He is Irish. He listens. Thank you, oh, thank you. I know the pressure from Mr. Wright, but please never forget. As I lay still awake, still in my mud, see my mud. I see no land. Let me sleep. Let me wake. I am all tired. Let me sleep. Thank you very much.